Hello, welcome to La Excellence. In our recap program, we are discussing monthly current affairs videos. In today's video, let us discuss August 2021 related issues. This is part 1 of the video. PDF of this video is available in the description. If you want to write test series based on monthly current affairs videos, you can enroll through the link given below. First, let us start with polity related issues. First issue is disruptions to the parliamentary functioning. Recently, in the recent monsoon session, we have seen huge disruptions in the functioning of parliament. In this context, the fundamental question is, what is the primary function of the parliament? How is it functioning? That is the issue. What are the functions of parliament? In chapter 2 and part 5 of Indian Constitution, functions of parliament are discussed. What are they? One is legislative function, that is to pass the bills with regard to all the matters related to union list and concurrent list. Second, in exceptional circumstances, it can pass law bills with regard to state list also. Second is executive functions, that is to have control over the executive through the instruments such as vote of no confidence, censure motion, cut motion, question hour, 0 hour, etc. Third one is financial functions, through the passage of money bills, finance bills, etc. Through the means of standing committees. Standing committees, they examine the grant of demand from various ministries. Amending powers of parliament, that is, parliament has the function and power to amend the constitution. Next, electoral functions. Parliament elects President of India and Vice President. And judicial functions. Parliament has privileges. Parliamentary members also have privileges. In case of breach of privilege, Parliament acts as a quasi-judicial body. It has the punitive powers to punish them. These are some of the functions of Parliament. This concept can be asked as a prelims question, let's say, which of the following are the functions of parliament, or which of the following are the instruments of parliament, that is legislative, to have control over executive. Such questions can be asked. Next issue is judicial appointments and collegium system. Recently, Supreme Court's collegium, headed by CJI, has recommended names of the Supreme Court judges. And President of India has cleared 9 names. This is the first time this huge number of judges are appointed at a time. Then, what is the meaning of collegium system? How judges are appointed? Under Article 124, Supreme Court judges are appointed by President of India. Under Article 217, Indian Constitution allows a President of India to appoint High Court judges. In the appointment and transfers of judges to the higher judiciary, there are many cases, such as first judge's case, second judge's case, third judge's case. Finally, in the third judge's case, it is said that CJI and 4 senior most Supreme Court judges, together they form a group. That group is known as collegium. This group recommends the names to President of India. Based on this recommendation, President of India appoints the judges to High Court as well as to the Supreme Court and transfers based on their recommendation. This system is known as collegium system. It is not mentioned anywhere in the Constitution. It is through various judicial interpretations this collegium system came into existence. The word collegium is not there in our Indian Constitution. Collegium suggests certain names. From these names, President of India appoints. It is not mandatory that all the names given by the collegium needs to be cleared by the President of India or needs to be appointed as the judges by the President of India. Right? There is no compulsion in that. Next issue is Gorkhas not to be tagged as foreigners. In Assam, NRC, National Registry for Citizenship, this is implemented, under which 19 lakh people are declared as out of this particular list. What is the purpose of NRC? In 1985, there is an accord known as Assam Accord. It is a tripartite accord. That means it is signed between Government of India, State Government and all Assam Students Union, under which there is a clause called Clause 6 of this accord. This accord says that the indigenous people's rights will be protected and those who have entered into India illegally, they will be deported. That is the provision. In that context, Gorkhas, are these people indigenous or are they come from other place? Gorkhas are original inhabitants of Nepal. But there are 25 lakh Gorkhas in Assam as of now. Recently, Assam government has released a notification saying that Gorkhas not to be tagged as foreigners though their names are not in NRC. Why? Because there is an agreement between British India and Gorkhas with regard to their citizenship. They have special privileges. They have actively participated in the many wars that are fought. Even now, Gorkha regiment is famous in Indian army. That is why Gorkhas, from many centuries, they are there in India. That is the reason why this recent notification was released by Assam government saying that Gorkhas are not to be tagged as foreigners. Next issue is right to be forgotten. In India, right to be forgotten is not a fundamental right, is not mentioned under any statute. In this context, there is no legal sanction yet for this particular right. But we can interpret it as part of our right to privacy, which is declared as fundamental right under Puttaswamy case. Now, what is the meaning of right to be forgotten? Data, information, images, anything that exists on the internet that becomes old, outdated, or not relevant, that needs to be removed. So the data, that photos, videos, whatever that the individual has, right to be forgotten. So such right is part of the fundamental right of privacy. Next, let us discuss geography related issues. Our first issue is interior of Mars. Mars, similar to Earth, is a terrestrial planet. It has three layers: crust, mantle, and core. In this context, InSight lander was sent by NASA to study the interior of the Mars. According to this, Mars planet experiences Mars quakes similar to earthquakes. These are seismic waves. According to the study of these Mars quakes, Mars doesn't have tectonic plates like Earth, but it has volcanically active regions. Through these volcanically active regions, when the volcanic eruption happens, it trembles. That leads to Mars quakes. Next issue is Gilgit-Baltistan region. Recently, Pakistani authorities are trying to introduce a constitutional amendment bill to add Gilgit-Baltistan as the new province in Pakistan. As of now, Gilgit-Baltistan is an autonomous province in Pakistan. Now it wants to have full administrative control over it. That is why it is introducing this particular thing. Now, where is this region, Gilgit-Baltistan? It is on that side of LOC. China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, it moves through this particular region. This is strategically very, very important because it is a high altitude territory on the northwestern corner of our Ladakh Union Territory. And it is strategically located on the borders of Pakistan, Afghanistan, China from India. That is why this region is very, very important. And India has protested against this particular bill. Next issue is Agalega Island. It is an island in the Indian Ocean region. It belongs to Mauritius. India and Mauritius have made a deal to build a jetty, to refurbish jetties, to build a airport terminal, and to extend the runway in this particular island. So it was reported that India is building military base in this region. Mauritius has denied that. That is why it's in news, Agalega Island. Similarly, we have Assumption Island here. This Assumption Island belongs to Seychelles. Mauritius and this one more island is there, known as Diogo Garcia. Chagos is the name of the island, Chagos Islands. Diogo Garcia is part of Chagos Islands. Next issue is glacial retreat in the Ladakh region. Let us briefly understand the geography of Ladakh. Ladakh is known as cold desert. Ladakh plateau is known as cold desert. This is Karakoram range. Here we have Siachen glacier, Ladakh range, Jeskar range. Here we have Greater Himalayas. And this is known as Ladakh plateau. This region is occupied by China. We call it as Aksai Chin region. And we have various rivers that flow through this. One is Shayok River, tributary of Indus. Then this is Indus River. Indus is the major river that flows through Ladakh. Just go through your map book once. This map is not clear. Now, what is glacial retreat? Fast melting of glaciers leading to depletion of the extent of glacier is known as glacial retreat. So that is observed in all the regions because of global warming and climate change.
Ladakh is in the third pole region. Towards this side, it has Himalayas. Towards north, it has Karakoram ranges. So, Karakoram, Himalayas, Hindu Kush mountains together are called as third pole region. All these three together is called as third pole region. This third pole region is experiencing the negative impact of climate change and global warming, that is by glacial retreat. Right, this is Ladakh region, Himalayas, Jaskar range, Nubra, Shayok are tributaries of Indus. This is Aksai Chin region, this is Karakoram. Next issue is Atlantic meridional overturning circulation. This is an ocean current. This is a large system of ocean currents, combination of ocean current systems in the North Atlantic Ocean. So this, the speed of it and the direction of it is changing. That is why it's in use. Why? According to IPCC report, excess heat is leading to instability of this Atlantic meridional ocean circulation. Here we have to remember, ocean currents, they move on the surface of the ocean. But beneath the ocean also we have currents, counter currents. So this entire thing constitutes one cycle. The speed and the nature is changing because of global warming. That is the recent understanding. Next issue is forest fires in Greek and Turkey. Greek and Turkey regions have experienced very high temperatures. Because of that, in the month of August, huge forest fires have happened. There's loss of thousands of hectares of land, forest land. In this context, many islands in Greece and Turkey, they got affected. Here, between Turkey and Greece, we have Aegean Sea. There is an island known as Avia, very important Avia. This region got affected the most during the recent forest fires. This is Rhodes Island. Rhodes Island belong to Greece. Right, Avia, important. Olympia, this is a place where the ancient ancient games started at this place, Olympia. So this region also experienced high forest fires. Here we have to remember, these countries, they have common border with Mediterranean Sea. In the eastern Mediterranean region, they have conflict. They have conflict with regard to EEZ. In the previous months, we have discussed about it. Just try to quickly revise that once. Next issue is Meghadatu controversy. It's a place in Karnataka. As per the Kaveri Water Agreement, Karnataka says we want to build a barrage over here, which will help in storing some water. For this can be used for the urban areas such as Bangalore, etc. But Tamil Nadu says this will obstruct the water flow and it impacts the lower riparian state of Tamil Nadu. But Karnataka says whatever it's a share in the Kaveri water, that is only Karnataka is using. It is not using any of the excess amount. So that's why this is in controversy. They went to Supreme Court now. Now let us briefly understand about River Kaveri. It is known as Ponni in Tamil. It is known as Ganga of South. And it is the fourth largest river of South India. It is a sacred river of Southern India. It rises on Brahmagiri Hills of Western Ghats region in Karnataka and flows towards the eastern direction, and it meets the sea, Bay of Bengal, through Pondicherry. It has major tributaries such as Arkavati, Hemavati, Lakshmana Tirtha, Simsha, Kabini, Harangi. These are some of the tributaries of Kaveri River. Next issue is rainfall at Greenland summit. Greenland is an island. It's part of North America, but this island belongs to Denmark. Denmark is a European country. This Greenland is located within Arctic Circle. That means temperatures are generally very, very less. Arctic Circle region. That is why it experiences precipitation in the form of snow and ice only. But recently, because of the increase in the temperatures due to global warming, climate change, especially this phenomena known as Arctic amplification, more impact of the increase in temperatures in the Arctic region is known as Arctic amplification. This phenomena has led to rainfall for the first time in the recorded history in Greenland. That is why it was in news. Next issue is Chagos Archipelago. In this video, when we discussed about Mauritius and Agalega Island, we said Chagos Archipelago and group of Chagos Islands are part of Mauritius. Yes or no? This is in news because UK claims Chagos Islands as its own territory.
But Mauritius say, no, we got independence from you, so that is ours. That is the conflict. UN and the International Court of Justice has said that Chagos Island should be given to Mauritius and legally it belongs to it, but UK rejected that. Chagos Archipelago is a combination of many islands including Dioga Garcia, Egmont Islands, Danger Islands, Eagle Islands, etc. Dioga Garcia is given to USA as a lease by UK. Dioga Garcia is an island in Chagos Archipelago. Chagos Islands are in conflict between Mauritius and UK. And these all are part of Indian Ocean region. Next issue is Siachen Glacier Operation Blue Freedom. Recently, a group of people with disabilities, they scaled Siachen Glacier that has created record. What is the Siachen Glacier? Siachen Glacier is located to the north of Ladakh region. This is in the eastern Karakoram range in Himalayas. And it is to the north of NJ 9842. NJ 9842 is one of the border posts over here. Pakistan says from NJ 9842 the border moves towards this direction, but India says no, it moves in this direction. That is why this tri-junction region is it's a strategic location. It is in conflict. So Siachen Glacier is a conflict between India and Pakistan. Now it is considered the second largest glacier in the world after Fedchenko Glacier in the non-polar regions. In polar regions, there are many glaciers, bigger ones. But these are bigger ones in non-polar areas. Siachen Glacier is world's highest battlefield and India has full administrative control over it since 1984 after Operation Meghadoot. In 1984, it is under our control. Next issue is Umlingla Pass. Umlingla Pass is located very near to LAC, line of actual control. Recently, BRO, Border Roads Organization, has completed world's highest motorable road at Umlingla Pass in the eastern Ladakh region. That is why this is the news. Earlier, Khardungla, near Leh city, this was the highest motorable road. Now, Umlingla Pass region is the highest motorable road. This is strategically very important. Next, let us understand history and art and culture related issues. First one is Abanindranath Tagore. Abanindranath Tagore's 150th birth anniversary is celebrated recently. So in this context, let us briefly understand about the contributions of Abanindranath Tagore towards the Indian art and culture. He first created Indian Society of Oriental Art and later established Bengal School of Art. He has modernized Mughal and Rajput painting, and most of his themes revolve around Hindu philosophy. Some of the famous paintings of him include Bharat Mata, very important, Bharat Mata, Passing of Shah Jahan, My Mother, Fairyland Illustration, Journey's End. These are some of the famous paintings of Abanindranath Tagore. Next issue is Partition Horrors Remembrance Day. August 14th is declared as Partition Horrors Remembrance Day to acknowledge the pain of partition in India. So partition happened as per the Mountbatten plan. Some of the provinces at the time, such as Punjab and Bengal, they were bifurcated. Some part of Bent went to Pakistan, other part in India. That led to huge scale migration of people as refugees, communal violence happened. So as a remembrance of that day, August 14 is declared as Partition Horrors Remembrance Day. Next issue is Edakkal Caves. These are the caves in Wayanad region of Kerala. This belongs to Mysore Plateau. Edakkal Caves are part of Wayanad of Kerala, and they are famous for the pictorial paintings, cave paintings. These are Stone Age carvings. These are not paintings but stone carvings, and they indicate the Neolithic period and Neolithic cultures. Next issue is Pashmina shawls and traditional textiles. Pashmina shawls are fine variant of shawls that are spun from Kashmiri wool. Changtangi goats, these are domesticated goats. From them wool is collected, and from this these shawls are made. Pashmina shawls are known for its softness. Recently these were in use because the local government is trying to encourage more and more women to enter into this traditional handicraft, to weave the Pashmina shawls. One that encourages the women leads to women empowerment. Two, it promotes employment. So that is why traditional textiles, employment, empowerment, these are all linked. That is why recently that initiative was started. Next issue is Tokyo Olympics. Tokyo 2020, this Olympics held in 2021 in Tokyo city of Japan. Let us briefly understand the historical background of Olympics. Olympic Games originated in ancient Greece. Modern Olympics started in 19th century. There is this IOC, International Olympics Committee. It's a not-for-profit independent international organization, not belong to any government. Independent international organization for the commitment of the better world through sport. Next issue is Ek Bharat, Shreshth Bharat. Ek Bharat, Shreshth Bharat, as part of Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav was organized, a webinar was organized. Ek Bharat, Shreshth Bharat scheme is implemented, and under this scheme, it was announced in 2015 on the occasion of 140th birth anniversary of Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. It's implemented under the guidance of Ministry of Education. The objective of the scheme is to celebrate the cultural diversity of India. It aims to enhance the interaction and promote the mutual understanding through the concept of state pairing. That means one state, students belongs to one state, they go to another state, they visit that place, and from that state, students come to this state. So that is how interactions and mutual understanding between students happen under the scheme. These are the issues of part 1. Thank you very much. All the very best.